Hi, this is Patrick McDonald of HollywoodChicago.com. We are at the 54th Chicago International Film Festival, and we're on the red carpet for the premiere of Widows, directed by Steve McQueen of 12 Years a Slave. We'll be talking to Steve McQueen. We're also going to be talking to Viola Davis, the Oscar winner for Fences, Michelle Rodriguez, and Chicago author, and screenplay adapter Gillian Flynn. So stay tuned.
Our husbands aren't coming back. We're on our own. My husband left me the plans for his next job. All I need is a crew to pull it off.
Why should we trust you anyway?
Because I'm the only one standing between you and a bullet in your head.
It's what I've learned from men like your late husband. And my father, is that you reap what you sow.
Let's hope so.
How do you like playing characters that are a person that does something that they never expected to do? How do you like playing those types of characters?
I love it. Because then it's good to go back to my own life. And I find that it makes me less conservative. It makes me a little bit more reckless. That's all I'll say.
How has the depth of where you go as an actor and creating a character helped your soul in real life as a human being?
It gives me more empathy. That's the best thing about being an actor. It's a great question. It's the best thing about being an actor because one of the things you have to do as an actor, you can't judge a character. You can't judge it. Whoever they are is who they are. And you're sitting with them. You're literally, it's like you're having a therapy session with them every single day. And it's the most beautiful part and most healing part of what we do.
Who do you consider your mentor in film directing? And how do you honor what they taught you in each of your films?
I don't really have a mentor, really. Of course, growing up, you look at a lot of pictures, a lot of films. I don't really have a mentor. I just have a situation where I appreciate the storytelling. That's all, yes.
Okay. And this is an unusual source for a premise, a TV miniseries from 1983. What sparked your interest in the pursuit of adapting this for a film?
Well, I saw it when I was 13 years old for the first time, in The Plants Widows. And I just wanted to retell that story. It was something which was inside of, it just stayed with me. It really had a huge impression on me, and I was very grateful to sort of retell it.
When you think about your love for cinema, what's the first thing you think about?
Story.
So you are a veteran of ensemble films.
Yeah.
Was there anything that you learned in this ensemble that surprised you as an actor?
Yes. Oh, well, the lack of protein shake farts was amazing. The air was a lot more fragrant, should I say. Being in a trailer full of women was refreshing. The speak without speaking kind of reminded me of what I usually see the boys doing, where they're able to just nod at each other and they get it. And to have that camaraderie on a set, you know, aside from, you know, my BBFs like Vin and other few people that I've worked with time and time again, it's really amazing to have that with strangers. And it's a feminine thing. It's just, you know, you kind of get on the same page, you feel each other's energy. It's a gender thing, and it was just refreshing to have that experience because I never had it before.
What can Lenny Ortiz do that Michelle Rodriguez cannot do?
Letty Ortiz has a lot less to worry about than I do. So let's just say she'll take a lot of chances that I usually wouldn't.
How was adapting a screenplay that was not your own source work, and where was the sticking point in adapting a longer TV show to a more cohesive movie screenplay?
You know, it was the first time I had adapted someone else's work, but I adapted it in the same way, which was I kind of looked at it once, you know, and kind of took my notes, and that's kind of what I did with Gone Girl when I adapted. I re-looked at it once, and I didn't let myself go back because, to me, it has to be a new thing, and you can't be constantly toggling back and forth, you know, between the source material and what it is. So I looked at Linda LaPlante's amazing miniseries, I took my notes, and then we kind of took that. I mean, it was, it's a great miniseries. It was so ahead of its time. But we, you know, we took what we loved from that and then said, okay, we got to move forward now, and made it our own. Yeah.
So great to see you again.
You too. Hey.
Congratulations.
Thank you.